Hi, I'm Betty. Welcome to Betty's Kitchen. Today we're making cabbage casserole. I'm making that for St. Patrick's Day because I'm going to be doing or have done some corned beef and also corned beef sandwiches. So it's really nice to have an accompaniment that goes really well with corned beef, and a natural is cabbage. So cabbage casserole for us. I want to show you my preparation of the cabbage. You want to take a medium-sized head and wash it and pat it dry, and then you can start chopping it. The way this has been chopped is been to get quarters, and then from that divide in half and you would have eighths. After you get your 1/8, then go down the middle of that and these will be 1/16. So those are too long to really put in your mouth, so you want to chop crosswise, and that's where these have come from. So you have 1/16 for wedges, but then take half of that, so you would have about like that, and it of course comes apart as you heat it. Over here on the stove, I have a large pot, and I have it about half full of water, and I'm going to put some salt in there, to taste. It might be a teaspoonful, and then we'll put our cabbage in. Here is our cabbage, and it's cooking gently in this boiling water, and I've been checking it occasionally with a fork because it needs to get tender, and it's almost there. Since it's almost there, I want to keep an eye on it, and I'm going to start mixing up a sauce that will go over the drained cabbage. In a medium-sized to large-sized saucepan, we're going to place 1 cup of milk. To that, we're adding 1/4 cup of melted butter. Next comes some salt and pepper. I have 1 teaspoon salt and 1/4 teaspoon ground black pepper. I'm going to stir that. And then I'm going to add cubes of Velveeta cheese. Now this is a variety of Velveeta that is sharp cheddar cheese. So this is going to have a sharp tanginess that typically you won't get from Velveeta cheese. If you prefer the milder variety, just get regular Velveeta, and then use 8 ounces that you have cubed so that it will melt easier. Put that in your mixture, stir it around, take it to the stove, and let this cheese melt. This is over low to medium heat, and you need to stir it occasionally. Our cabbage is tender, so I'm going to turn that off. And then I'm bringing it over to the sink and draining it through a colander. I have my cabbage put in the casserole. This is a 13 by 9 by 2 inch Pyrex dish. So use something similar to that, that's oven proof. And then we're going to pour our cheese sauce over the top. And you'll see that the cheese is melted. There might be a lump here or there. That's okay, because that will melt eventually. Just pour this right over the top. And it looks nice and generous, which it should be. Now this goes to a 375 degree oven. It's going to bake about 20 to 30 minutes. But 10 minutes in, I'm going to put these crushed Ritz cracker crumbs on the top. I've already made these with a rolling pin, and so they're ready to go. But if I put them on now, they may get a little over brown. So after 10 minutes, those get added, but then I continue to bake it until the full 20 or 30 minutes are up, and I'll judge when to take it out of the oven based on its appearance at that point. Our cabbage casserole is just out of the oven and it's done, and you can see that it has the Ritz cracker crumbs over the top. I put those on after 10 minutes of baking, and then I let it bake another 10 minutes. So it's had a total of 20 minutes in the oven. And you may omit the cracker crumbs if you don't want them there. So just cook it for 20 minutes. It should be fine. I'm going to serve some onto a plate here and take a test bite for you. I'm ready to take my taste. I have my drink all ready to go here. And I'm just going to take some from any part. It's all the same. It's a big bite, but I've let it cool about 5 minutes, so I don't think it's going to burn my tongue. It tastes yummy. It is so tender. Usually when you think about cooking cabbage, you think that there are stalks in it and things like that. I actually cut the core out, so I didn't use that in this. But the rest is just cooked to perfection. Cooking it on the stove for a little bit till it's tender, and then baking it in the casserole is perfect. And for those of you who like your vegetables covered up with cheese sauce and Ritz crackers and all of that, you'll get it in this recipe. I can taste the cabbage, I get the feel and texture of the cabbage, but there's a lot of flavor of sharp cheese coming from that sharp Velveeta cheese. So I think you'll like this, and it's a great pairing to go with corned beef.